you'll feel your coronal suture. You should be able to feel it, and you should be able to feel it through your clothing. We should be able to see it. Although you have a nice round head. A lot of people, you can see their sutures, and there's no hair. But I can feel mine here, and it's not hard to feel at all. If she's laying on the table, okay, there's just a tiny ridge. She has a pretty even head, so you don't have to worry. Okay, but there's just a ridge. It goes around. You can feel it on all of us. It goes about halfway back. So I want to lift this up. Well, there's nothing that's blocking this, so we're going to do it two ways. I first learned to do it this way, and this technique made a lot of sense to me, and I liked it. And the next technique, I thought it was not a good technique, and I said, this is stupid, I'm not going to do it. And now I do both. So I feel like I get a lot from both. I put very light, medium pressure on her, and I'm going to lift the ceiling. These will be the techniques that you'll do that people will tell you. They feel something floating. They might feel a little dizzy when they get up. It's not a bad dizzy. It's dizzy because they're relaxing. I have one patient comment. They thought I was praying for them. Inside I am, but that's not what I'm doing. My hands are touching, so my hands are more steady this way. You can do this without your fingers touching each other, but then my hands are less steady. You're going to end up putting more pressure on her head. And I do this to people that have a full-blown migraine, that are in tears, coming in my office wearing dark sunglasses. I call it the migraine shuffle, pushing one foot in front of the other foot again, walking in very slowly. I'm going up to the ceiling. How was that?
Relaxing.
Good. Okay, now, here's the way that I thought was stupid. I'm going to use two or three fingers. You can use as many as you want. I'm going to put my fingers on the anterior surface and do the same thing. From here, I'm wanting to come around, put just a little bit of pressure, medial and up. It shouldn't be anything like that. You're not crushing their head. You're just touching. And that's why I can control my grip this way. This way I don't have as much control. I still know where it is in three-dimensional space, but I don't have as much control as I do this way. So I put some medial pressure and then go up to the ceiling. This way is skin pressure. It is this and up. And I said, how am I supposed to touch the anterior surface and lift the anterior? It's like asking me to lift the table by levitation. Okay? I can lift the table this way. How am I supposed to lift it this way? Well, it's skin tension. And there's some elements of... Let me just do it.
The first one feels better.
Feels better? Most people will tell me the second one does. Although it doesn't matter, She feels what she feels with everyone staring at her. Okay? So I used to say, with this one I think I'm getting something, with this one I think I'm wasting my time. What I've found is, at least I don't go by patient reports. Patients report to me more this one, they feel that floating sensation. I don't look for that sensation to tell me I'm doing it right. But here there's nothing holding the frontal bone on. The face is pretty loose. The face, we're not doing the face as part of and it's part of this weekend. But the face is actually quite loose. I can grab parts of your face and wiggle them. It will really feel weird to you, but your face is far away and it will move. This is sitting on top of the coronal suture. So it's easy to lift this off. It's not other bones stopping it. So this is skin tension. I'm bringing my fingers as much as I can together without coming off. And sometimes you get patients, some people are greasy and you slide on their skin, you can't help it. So I just do what I can do. I do both of them. And it should be either nothing or it should be pleasant. Our goal is to just lift this. If I just stop here, I can feel our cranial rhythm here. I can feel it from here. I can do it from the vault hold here. My goal is if I increase mobility, then whatever motility she has, whatever normal motion her body is going through, it should go through it better, more, bigger, louder. Not necessarily faster, but
more. The second, your direction is towards you?
They're both up here. The first one is medial compression and then up, but it is not a grip. Okay, don't grip their head. Just